Hello, my name is Dragos and I am the owner of the site wpdas.com. In this video, I would like to show you how you can backup your WordPress site to Dropbox or Google Drive for free. The backups will be done automatically and you don't need to do any manual backups. Periodically, the plugin will do it automatically for you. First, let's start with some WordPress backup best practices so you understand what are the most important aspects that you should take into consideration when you are backing up your WordPress site. So first, you should not store the backups in the same server or under the same account as your websites. It's not good to have everything in one place. If someone will hack your account where your website, it can delete also the backups. So that's why you need to backup your WordPress site into external sources like Dropbox, Google Drive, or other FTP FS or SFTP accounts that you may have that are not related with your account. So the second aspect is the backup frequency. This is basically how often you schedule your automatic backup. In case you're publishing 2 or 3 articles a day, you will need to backup your site more often. So in case you need to restore from backup to not lose a lot of informations. So the plugin will help you choose the schedule in function of your needs. So you don't, even if your hosting provider offers backup for you, it is not good to only rely on them. In case something happened, like their backups is not working, or maybe they lock down your account, or maybe they take a long time to restore your backup, you would want to have a backup of your own that you can use and restore your website fast. The fourth best practice is to test your backup. You would want for the backup to work, so you can only see if everything is working properly if you restore your backup in a test subdomain. So you should do this from time to time and see that your backup is good and is not having any issues. The fifth one is to check the backup logs. From time to time, it is good to check the backup log and see that the backups are done without any errors. So in case you need the backup to have a good one and not have problems. And the last one is the backup retention period. You may have your WordPress hacked, let's say 3 weeks ago, and you didn't notice until now. So in order to restore your backup in the place where your website was clean and not hacked, you need to have the backup from that period. That's why it's a good practice to store multiple backups for a long period of time, and you restore the backup when the website was good, and afterwards you can import the articles. So right now we'll move to the steps that you need to do to backup your WordPress site. For this tutorial, we will use a quite new plugin, WPvivid backup plugin, that it is very good, and it is also offering possibility to migrate your WordPress site besides automatically backing up your WordPress sites. So the first step is to have our WordPress plugin installed. To do this, we'll need to go to the WordPress dashboard. I have it here, and go under plugins, add new, and we search for this plugin. We type WPvivid here. And we install it and activate it. Let's wait for the plugin to install, and then we can activate it and configure our automatic backup. Okay, right now we have our backup plugin installed. We just need to go and configure the plugin to backup our WordPress site. In the left side here you have the tab with the settings. We need to go to the remote storage. The first step is, the second step is to configure where we want to have our backups. You can choose any of these locations. You can back it up on Google Drive or Dropbox. On this video I will choose Google Drive. The same steps you need to do for Dropbox if you want to use Dropbox. Here we'll put a name for our remote storage. I will call it WPvivid site. I will make this the default remote storage, and then we need to authenticate to Google Drive. We hit this button, and next we choose our Google account. And we allow WPvivid to access this account. Okay, right now we have the plugin configured for the remote storage. Next we need to schedule the automatic backup. We do it from here, from the schedule tab. Here we enable the backup schedule. Here we have the options for the backup from 12 hours to 12 hors, daily, weekly, fortnightly, and monthly. I will choose the weekly because I am not publishing that many articles on this site. Here I let the database and the file, so in this way will backup my entire site, and I want to save the backup to the remote storage that I've configured previously, and then we just hit save. Right now the automatic backup is configured, and in this area here you see that schedule status is enabled, and here you see the server time, and here you'll see when the next backup it will happen. Next we need to configure some of the settings of the plugin. In case we have a limit for the file size imposed by your host, you can put here the limit. For instance, I like to have 500 megabytes files. The plugin will split automatically the backup into 500 megabytes files. Here we have the options to exclude the files, but I'll turn on modify. Here is the execution time. I will let the default one. The memory is the same. Here is the backup retention period. I will choose 5 to have 5 weeks of backup. And I will let these options by default. Here we have the backup folder for the local backups. Here we have the options to remove the database backups. Here we have the options to compress the backups to reduce space, but it will utilize more resources. We have the options to send an email with a report, but I will not choose this. Here you can export the settings, but I will let it like this and hit save. So right now we have everything configured for the automatic backup. What we need to do next, if it is the first time when you're using a backup plugin or you don't have a backup for your WordPress site, is just to run a manual backup to have a copy stored before the automatic backup will kick in. So here we choose the database and file. Here we choose the send backups to remote storage. This will backup the WordPress site to the storage you configure, Google Drive in our case. And right now we hit backup now. And now the backup will start to run and it will take some time in function of your WordPress site. This site, it's small and it should not take that much to finish. It's already started here. It will finish in a couple of seconds. I'll pause the video until then. Okay, right now the backup has finished. As you can see here, if we check below, we see that we have a manual backup done here. In here, we have the log for it. If you want to check and see that everything is okay and there wasn't any errors, you see that it's completed successfully. In this area, you have also the options to download and restore it. Now we can check the Google Drive and see that the backup is actually there. Let's go and see. We go to Google Drive and here we should have a folder with the WPvivid backups. Here it is, WPvivid backup. If we go under it, just a second for this to open. If we go here, we see that we have the backup. I've previously done a test backup and that's why there are two, but this is the last backup. So right now we have also a copy of the site in the Google Drive. Next, what needs to be done is to wait for the automatic backup to kick in and after to check the logs and see that everything is okay, and check Google Drive and see that the automatic backup has been successfully transferred. Also, you may want to restore this first backup to a subdomain and be sure that it's okay and it doesn't have any problems. This is the tutorial that will help you to backup your WordPress site automatically for free. If you want, you can let a comment below and tell us what are the remote locations that you are using for your WordPress backups. Please don't forget to subscribe and like the video if you like it. Thanks, and we'll see you in the next video.